For the last 11 years, the United Nations has celebrated Chinese Language Day to promote multilingualism and cultural diversity. This year, we launched the world's first ever Chinese language video festival and invite viewers from around the globe to join us for a visual celebration of Chinese, brought to you from the CMG studio in London. Please welcome your host, Stephen Cole.
Hello and welcome. For those of you who don't know, the United Nations has six official languages: Arabic, Chinese, English, French, Russian, and Spanish. To be honest, it's a miracle anything ever gets done. But given that there are more than 7,000 languages in the world, six sounds like an excellent compromise. But why Chinese? Well, for a number of good reasons. In fact, a very large number of good reasons. Around 1.4 billion people, that's around 17% of the world's population, speak some form of Chinese as their first language, making it the most spoken language on the entire planet. On top of that, it's one of the oldest languages still in use today, with its origins dating back around 5,000 years, which means the Chinese people can now still read the words of their far distant ancestors. No wonder, then, that the Chinese have such a deep-rooted trust in their ancient wisdom. For them, history and language are completely intertwined, so to study the language is to get a glimpse into thousands of years of incredible continuity and to gain extraordinary insights into their history, their culture, and most importantly, their values. With the first Chinese Language Video Festival, we'll be looking at how language learning can help break down barriers, cross cultures, and form a bridge that unites us all. Later, I'll be bringing you the results of the first Chinese Language Video Festival Awards, but first, to celebrate the arrival of spring, when, according to legend, the Chinese language was first invented by the great figure Sang Jia, here's a sublime video from one of China's most successful global influencers, a woman who embodies the universal desire to go back to our roots and reconnect with the earth. It is the incomparable Li Zhe.
Thank you.
Incredibly, Li Chi has more than 73 million followers on YouTube from all around the world. Clearly, working without words, without language, can sometimes make one's art more accessible. But sometimes, if we want to go deeper and get a greater understanding, we need language to be our guide. This piece by the Chinese artist Sa Ding Ding would be wonderful even without words, yet the addition of lyrics takes it to a whole new level, although the subtleties of Zen may be beyond a literal translation.
左手指就在于我要告诉你一个真理，我用手指向了月亮。其实你要忽略掉我的手，因为我要你看到的其实是月亮。你是我无二无别这一句呢，众生所有的众生所有的相，其实我也是你，你也是我，你中有我，我中有你。然后也是我们道家庄子的齐物论里面的一个核心内容。
手一弹指，右手弹这弦，舟楫摆渡在忘川的水里间。当烦恼能开出一朵莲，莫停歇，给我杂念。左手心。
古书那一刻，我就在想着，哇，先秦时代，那是一个怎样的时代？这些文字就来自于那样的一个时代，所以非常非常难得。我想每一个中国人的自信心和这个美好的一种家国情怀，都会要思考一下这个问题，就是我们是可以看到我们自己5000年之前的原版的文字。 所以这是一种感动。
The sublime Sa Ding Ding on how the incredible longevity of the Chinese language has meant that essential Chinese values, as she mentioned, the love for one's family and nation, have been passed down from generation to generation for thousands of years, just as the great Chinese philosopher Confucius found order and understanding in his studies of the past, so a group of young Chinese artists are taking inspiration from history as they strive to revive and recreate their own illustrious past.
三百，它不会把那个红色的那个，就是红白的对比就会比较厉害。有点脸谱化了，感觉。如果做的是纯复原妆容的话，那相对来说就要比较严谨，因为那个的话，可能我们是根据壁画或者是陶俑或者是一些墓葬，去根据它的这个要求去做一个整体的造型。那跟我们今天这种就会不一样，我们今天是根据那个音乐。 那相对来说，我们就会根据作品来做这个感觉。
这个是一个典型的那个南宋的被子，然后可以看到它这个衣缘这边我们是有一个泥金的一个印花，然后底下的话穿的是罗裙，那我们可以看到它这个裙子的话我们就没有做太长，是相对来说比较简洁的一个款式，脚下的话穿的是一双弓鞋，
古琴往左移吧，古琴移，再移，还要移，你看这里要形成一个圆弧，那个头的位置肯定不对啊。 好，到头了，停停停停停，好，涂老师要再往那边转，笛子再这样转，对，好好好，保持这个角度啊，好，再看一下啊，最后的那个炫技手要再大一点，别人你这个谁知道你在炫技啊，明白了，好，再来一次啊。 对，抬手，对了，棒极了，就是这意思。啊，这次实录了，大家打起精神。好，开机。
That piece is a reimagining of music as it was played thousands of years ago, based on details written in ancient Chinese literature. Now, if you were looking closely, you'll have noticed red stamps in the background that state the exact names of the clothes, hairstyles, and makeup that were worn in the Tang and Song dynasties, as well as in this video. Only a fluent Chinese speaker could possibly grasp these small but fascinating details on their own. But now, with something a little more up to date, a few words from Ambassador Chan Xiu.
尊敬的瓦罗瓦亚总干事，尊敬的盛海雄台长，女士们、先生们、朋友们，大家好！在这样一个春暖花开、春意盎然的季节，我很高兴与各位新老朋友在云端相聚，共同参加联合国中文日活动。我要特别感谢联合国日内瓦办事处、中央广播电视总台为本次活动做出的贡献。中文是中华文明的重要标志，蕴含着丰富的文化寓意。比如说，今天活动主题的“春”字，它在甲骨文里是由新芽、绿草和太阳的字符共同构成的，既展现出“阳春布德泽，万物生光辉”的美好景象，同时也表达着春日耕耘、期盼收获的乐观精神。它还体现了中华文化包容并蓄、和谐共生的精神品格。语言是人类交流沟通的载体，是国家交往联系的桥梁，也是文明互学互鉴的纽带。中文作为联合国官方语言之一，为促进世界各国之间的沟通交流，发挥着非常重要的作用。随着越来越多的外国朋友学习中文，感受中国文化，我相信世界将会更加深入地了解一个底蕴深厚、勤劳友善的中国，一个创新发展、开放包容的中国。中国也必将以更加开放的姿态拥抱世界，以更有活力的文明成就贡献世界。多年来，联合国中文日的活动已经成为人们了解中华文化的重要窗口。它不仅为大家提供了一个感知中国的独特平台，同时也促进了世界语言、文化之间的交流。正如习近平主席指出的，推进人类各种文明的交流交融、互学互鉴，是让世界变得更加美丽，各国人民生活变得更加美好的必由之路。中国常驻日内瓦代表团愿同有关各方加强沟通、增进了解、促进合作，为建设一个更加美好的世界而共同努力。祝愿本次联合国中文日活动取得圆满成功，谢谢大家。
Thank you, Ambassador Chan Xiu, for your warm words. Now, as mentioned, one of the purposes of Chinese Language Day is to promote multilingualism and cultural diversity, not just around the world, but at the UN itself. So let's take a look at how they're doing.
Oh, God.
我希望我的中文Ah, no, sorry, I forgot.
Oh, I'm sorry.
中文很难。
笑一笑是年少，这样你可以让你自己开心一点，或者你可以让别人开心一下。
风雨送春归，飞雪迎春到。已是悬崖百丈冰，犹有花枝俏。
不但这个电影的主题很有意思，而且我真的喜欢主神的幽默。
我在北京待了很多年。我在北京医科大学学习医学，在电视上我看了那个《红楼梦》，对我很有影响。
春眠不觉晓，处处闻啼鸟， 夜来风雨声，花落知多少。
我希望我的中文越来越好。
Obviously, learning Chinese, like any language, takes plenty of practice and perseverance. But vlogger Stuart Wigan, aka C2 Jian Gua, has taken his language learning to some dizzying heights.
Hello, I'm C2 Jian Gua. I'm in Sichuan, Liangshan Yizhou. Now, Liangshan is one of the most poverty-stricken areas in the whole of China, perhaps the most. This year, more than 18,000 residents moved into newly built homes who previously lived in a rather well-known village known as Atuliartun. I'm going to go and see Atuliartun. But in order to get there, I need to climb. Atuliartun is also known as Shuanyatun, which literally means cliff edge village. Previously, villagers would have to climb about 17 ladders made from wood and vine and rope. It would take half a day just to enter and exit the village. But those ladders were replaced in 2019. The government paid to install this steel ladder that I'm walking up now. 2,556 steps, so I'm told. Pretty hard. You know, that made travelling easier, made the journey quicker, but it didn't solve the problem of the 84 households that were situated in Shuanyatun. There's no hospital at the top of the village, no school. Moving supplies, pretty difficult. Getting in and out, obviously, hard. Oh my God. I haven't even started. I'm waiting all the guys, 40 minutes. I have a bar.
You're
from where? Oh, English. You're going to say Sichuan Hua, right? So in May of this year, the villagers at Shuanyatun, they walked down this ladder to their newly built homes in that relocation community, leaving behind a village that their ancestors lived in since the Yuan dynasty back in the 13th and 14th century. So obviously, it must have been emotionally difficult for some of them to leave their ancestral home. But now, they don't have to climb this ladder to go see the doctor, walk along here to go get supplies. Everything they need is at their doorstep. This is ridiculously hard. This is so hard. Going down must be harder. I'm dreading that. This isn't an ideal situation for anyone.
My back hurts, my leg hurts, my back hurts, my chest hurts. I know a part. When you climb up, you think about it, wow, this is too hard.
If I was a villager living at the top of this mountain, I don't know what I'd do. Just having a bit of a rest. So, actually, tourists come here now to see Atuliartun. So this has turned into an example of Luofupian, poverty alleviation by tourism, if the tourists can get to the top. I don't think I'm going to get to the top.
不累吗？习惯了是吗？
我想坐在上面讲课的。
啊，是吗？
还要上去吗？
我觉得我不行。我们只到一半是不是？
还没到一半
吧，还没到一半
啊！
哇，那我不行。
加油！
啊，谢谢。So those guys not tired at all. 我累死了。哎，不好意思。背着什么东西？
衣服。
衣服。你是住在？
对，
是。这上面是吗 ？So some people obviously still live up the top of Shuanyatun because the tourists go in there. So.There's an industry up there now, but the majority of the 84 households have relocated. Oh, I think I'm going to go down. I think I'm going to go down.
Oh my God. 下去更难. Oh God. This is ridiculously hard. Do you feel a little
bit? Yeah,
a little bit. You're
hard.
Carrying a bed up, unbelievable. 没到悬崖村，但是飞机拍到了，所以算去了，是不是？我只到了一半。OK， 现在去南平社区。啊， And here I am at Nanping Shechu at the Daozhou County Poverty Alleviation Relocation Site. This place is huge. It's really, really nice. This is much nicer than my Xiaoqiu in Beijing. What I really like is everyone's got a balcony. I want a balcony. Also, wooden carvings on the building. Yizhu, I'm not sure. They look nice though. I think one of the most important things about this place is there is a school right here, just nearby. So the kids obviously don't have to travel that far to get to school, whereas before, obviously had to travel an extremely long distance.
Hey, Shetu, you didn't wear glasses?
Yeah. Ah, left them on the ladder.
The incredible language skills of Stuart Wiggin, allowing him to reach or almost reach places few other foreigners have ever been. But speaking Chinese doesn't just allow you to be the consummate tourist. For some foreigners, learning Chinese has allowed them to take their passions to a whole new level.
Ciao a tutti, sono Gianluca Luisi, italiano e sono un promotore della cucina cinese nel mondo. 我之前是在中国先读了两年的研究生，然后在意大利驻重庆总领事馆。
当地人说重庆的那个气候啊，太潮湿了。
都比较吃了那个潮热的出汗，也是说出汗嘛。他吃了医生，感觉医生很清爽一种。我当时决定离开意大利驻重庆总领事馆的时候，其实我的想法很简单，我以前是把意大利的各种好的故事、好的东西推广到中国这边来，我现在。 做的东西是一模一样，但是可能位置不同而已，角度不同而已。我现在应该是要把中国的美食的故事，中国美食的一些元素、一些特点推广到全球。另外呢，我觉得在全球很多地方我们会看到很多国家都有自己一个具有代表性的辣酱，但是中国又没有一个在国外能够真的就是进入当地的这个主流社会的这么一个产品，一个辣酱。所以我现在创办了一个品牌，然后在这个品牌旗下，我研发了各种各样的有中国味道的辣椒酱。我希望就是通过这样的一个事情，能够把中国的美食文化推广出去。 对我不是一个负担，对我来说不是一份工作，对我来说是一个故事。那我可能现在是这个故事的总编，我希望就能够写出一个能够引得大家尊重的一个故事，能够对得起中国美食文化的一个故事。
依然难。 Ambassador Chen Shu, Mr. Shen Haixiong, President of China Media Group, dear friends, it is my pleasure to open this virtual Chinese Language Film Festival on the occasion of Chinese Language Day 2021. I would like to sincerely thank Ambassador Chen Shu and the Permanent Mission of People's Republic of China, as well as Mr. Shen Haixiong, the President of China Media Group, for sharing their rich cultural and linguistic heritage with us here in International Geneva and beyond. Language Days have been celebrated at the United Nations since 2010 to support multilingualism and cultural diversity through the organization. They aim to raise awareness of the history, culture, and achievements of all the six official languages of the United Nations. International Mother Language Day, celebrated last month, provided another important opportunity to safeguard and promote the linguistic diversity of all 193 United Nations member states. The Chinese language is the most widely spoken language in the world, and it is also one of the oldest. With over 100,000 characters and counting, the language is an ample repository of Chinese wisdom, culture, and traditions. China is also among the greatest contributors to our common cultural heritage, ranking first in UNESCO's Intangible Cultural Heritage List. With one of the most dynamic economies in the world, and the second largest contributor to the United Nations budget, China is a vital partner for the United Nations. As the world continues to face wide-ranging challenges triggered by the COVID-19 pandemic, we count more than ever on China's continued commitment to multilateralism. Multilingualism truly is a cornerstone of effective multilateralism. The pandemic has exposed language barriers in societies around the world. Marginalized groups and linguistic minorities have struggled to get access to quality and timely information. In order to secure a robust and coordinated global response to the pandemic, we first need to understand each other. As we build back better, using the Sustainable Development Goals as our guide, ensuring multilingualism in recovery plans is essential. I would like to thank once again the organizers of this event for reminding us of the importance of multilingualism, as well as the influence and beauty of the Chinese language showcased in these magnificent video works. I wish you all an enjoyable film festival. Thank you very much.
And thank you, Tatiana Valuvaya, Director General of the United Nations at Geneva. Now, many foreigners may find Chinese pronunciation difficult, but even if they don't speak it fluently, just understanding it, as our next subject, Alex Hua Tian, does, can be enormously helpful.
As a person, I identify myself as a rider. I ride horses. You know, it's not only my occupation, but it's very much my life. It's my passion. But a very important part of my identity is being Chinese and British. My mother's British, my father's Chinese. I grew up in China until I was 11 and then moved to the UK for school. I represent China, but in a very traditionally British sport. So I kind of feel that my identity is very, very mixed, but it doesn't mean that I'm any less proud to be Chinese or British.
When Amy said, you want to come and do a coverage of the Chinese Language Day, I was like, 但是我中文不够好.
Yes.
Daddy, you got to turn the camera around. We'll do it sideways. We'll do it sideways like this. Oh, there we are. I can see you. I can see you. I think I'm very lucky with my parents that I've always been taught to be very comfortable in both cultures.
Do you remember that tongue twister we did in Beijing?
Pao bing bing pai. Despite the fact that my spoken Chinese isn't very good, I'm still very comfortable moving around in China. And normally, you know, before pre-pandemic, I would normally spend a few days every month in China. I have a very unique perspective, being half-half, in that I can understand and empathize with sometimes opposing points of view. And for me, certainly the last couple of years have been relatively saddened and at times frustrated by the general lack of understanding. I remember when I first went to my first Olympics when I was 18 years old, so very young, very naive, and I thought, you know, through the whole process of qualifying, this is all about me. And I arrived at the Olympics, 15,000 athletes, suddenly you realize you're a drop in the ocean. It was very humbling, but at the same time, it was very uplifting because you feel part of something so much bigger than yourself. The philosophy behind the Olympics is so great, and it's even better when you're part of it. It doesn't matter whether we're Chinese, British, American, you know, South African, Argentinian, it doesn't matter. We've all got to share the planet together. We all have to understand each other. This is what I try to say to people. We don't have to agree with each other, but understanding is more important than agreeing.
Understanding is more important than agreeing. Well, tragically, the coronavirus pandemic has affected everyone over this last year, and understanding between cultures has become more important than ever. Thankfully, the Japanese documentary maker Ryo Takeuchi, who is fluent in Chinese, discovered a valuable aspect of Chinese culture that he's been able to share with the world. The belief that good and bad luck are not absolute, but are in fact complementary, interconnected, and often give rise to each other.
大家好，我是竹内亮。来自日本的拍纪录片导演。这些中文日野，我很高兴我的作品能在中文日的节目里出现。12月，私は約半年ぶりに武漢にやってきた。この1年、苦難の道を歩んできた武漢の人たち。私は街行く人を呼び止め、合計50人以上の人たちにこの1年を振り返ってもらった。
2020年你失去了什么？直接把失去的东西写在这个空地就行。我小孩失去了工作，失业了，就靠我来养。他是搞旅游的，他到过很多国家，可是疫情一来没有了，一切都没有了，没有办法。
疫情的时候不能出门，就不能和同学们一起玩，所以我写的是同学。哦，是我第一次遇到你这么多的周边，几乎所有的周边的人都感染的人。哎，对，我第一次遇到，因为已经走了一个了，就受不了了。所以话呢，我就说为什么讲失去了春天呢？整个春天我都在惶恐不安当中，就过去了，就整个春天。
不仅仅是我失去了，我认为呢，我们整个武汉人呐，整个湖北人，整个国家，对今年的春天抹不去这个记忆。2020年未曾有災難に見舞われた武漢。一方、先ほどの女性が言うように、失うものと得るものは表裏一体だ。そこで。
2020年，你得到了什么？就直接写一下。
我得到的应该也是亲情吧。
我觉得二零年挺好的
挺好的是吧
啊
哦
少了四个月的收入然后我也得到了亲情我们觉得没什么、哦、
所以你得到的东西比失去的东西多
对对对对对、
哦、
想到就是全国人民对湖北的帮助嘛这东西还是蛮感动的现在说起来全国的救援队到湖北来的时候任务完成之后走了就是我们大街小巷的去送他们嘛任务蛮感动
有很多人就把他们的生命留在了疫情里面像他们的时间可能就此停止了但是我们的时间还在继续着我们是不是应该花这些时间去做一些能为所有人做到的事情
所以更珍惜时间了
对更珍惜对这个珍惜
一年没见到是吧
一年多
今天才相见
这什么感觉终于见面了
终于见面了、啊、我们见面就拥抱了
自由了、
啊、
当时我爱人呢进行抢救的时候医生呢都下了病危通知单就说你爱人呢如果再发高烧再烧两天可能就救不回来了那个时候我感觉要失去他了到了我爱人出院的时候我都觉得好像是这个爱又回来了就是这样子最后我想得到了爱
仕込みなしのぶっつけ本番で行ったこの街頭インタビュー彼ら一人一人の表情こそがリアルな武漢だ
一些新的发现，
得到信息，
得到了很多帮助，
得到了一个假期，
更勇敢了吧？
得到了关爱，
得到新的，
得到了很多温暖的地方。
Thank you to Leo Takeuchi for his beautiful and thought-provoking film. And now, ladies and gentlemen, a few words from Mr. Shen Hai-xiong, president of the China Media Group.
瓦洛瓦亚总干事，程旭大使，全世界学习汉语，热爱中文。关注中国的朋友们，大家好，我在北京，对本次联合国中文日活动及中央广播电视总台首届海外影像节表示热烈的祝贺，感谢朋友们的参与和支持。今天是中国传统的24节气之一的谷雨，联合国中文日特意选在今天，别有意趣。谷雨承载了春去夏至的美好，代表了万物生长的景象，纪念了仓颉造字的创举。汉字是中国文化的根基。中国典籍《淮南子》说：“昔子仓颉著书，而天与树，鬼夜哭。”也就是说，中国人认为汉字的诞生是惊天地、泣鬼神的大事。逐渐，汉字在中国人精神世界中的神圣位置。当今世界，越来越多的海外人士爱上了汉字。大家知道，汉字是世界上最古老又很年轻的文字，说它古老，在于5000多年前，它就已经出现在华夏大地。说它年轻，就是这种古老的文字，至今还在使用。在3000多年前，中国殷商时期的甲骨文中的许多汉字，沿用至今。古老的汉字跨越了千秋万代，在人类的文化星空中依然熠熠生辉。文字是文化的载体，汉字之美，美在看得见的象形艺术，美在听得见的铿锵音韵，美在书的妙的言韵流骨，更美在中华文明5000年的历史 变迁，在世界文明的大花园里，不一样的文字和语言传递着不一样的文化魅力。雨果的法语，维吉尔的拉丁语，鲁拜吉的古波斯语等等，其背后都蕴含着各异奇趣的文化传承。2014年3月，习近平主席在联合国教科文组织总部的演讲当中强调，文明因交流而多彩，文明因互鉴而丰富。他说，世界上有200多个国家和地区，2500多个民族和多种宗教，如果只有一种生活方式，只有一种语言，只有一种音乐，只有一种服饰，那是不可想象的。一位法国汉学家也曾经说，他一生挚爱的四个汉字是和而不同。这四个字来自春秋战国时期的《论语》。的确，它完好地阐释了中国人对待世界的哲学，美美与共，和而不同。今天也是中央广播电视总台首届海外影像节大奖揭晓日。如果说文字展现的是一种静止的美，那么影像只是利用视觉语言和光影符号表达出的跃动之美。在这里，我祝贺所有获奖和参与的朋友们，你们用同一种语言，却让世界听到了不同的声音，而多种声音一个世界，正是联合国所追求的多元文化的境界。祝愿联合国中文日活动圆满成功，愿我们再次相聚，谢谢大家。
And thank you, President Shen Haixiong of the China Media Group. At the moment, around 200 million Chinese students are learning foreign languages in order to gain a better understanding of the wider world. But nothing makes Chinese people happier than when foreigners make the effort to speak Chinese and try to understand their culture, like this German choir did at the start of the pandemic and again in January of this year.我想四处走走，听雨听雪听海，听人潮汹涌。我不知道会不会在伤心或泪流，我知道学会珍惜此刻的所有。
Time of the Dawn Bells was for trying to help the people of Wuhan to stand the pandemic. And the day after was like a fire, you know. Every social media, every big media in China came, and the song was eventually seen by more than 100 million people. So I was very proud. This one that I write, I'm happy to do it for the UN Chinese Language Day. It would be a song to say it's over, this pandemic is over. Let's have a white page and start a new life. And I try to put it in my music, and I hope that people will feel it.
Flight. We wake up like the spring and the life it brings. The awakening of the world, the flowers unfurled, the eternal song that nature sings.
Thank you to Jean-François Maljean for that beautiful piece composed specially for the Chinese Language Video Festival. But our last word on the importance of language learning goes to Professor Alan McFarlane from King's College, University of Cambridge, with his own message of linguistic hope.
China is a huge place, and for thousands of years, the one thing that has really joined it together is the language, particularly the written language. And so it's important for China, but it's now important for the world as China establishes its place as one of the great civilizations again. It's very important that we in the West respect Chinese language, understand its role, and encourage our young people, if they wish to learn Chinese so that we can communicate between civilizations. It's really important that we both respect each other's identities, but also that we share in various activities which bring us together and collaborate. It's like musical harmony. We can be different instruments in an orchestra, a violin or a drum or whatever, but also we play the same tunes and we respect each other.
Thank you, Professor McFarlane. And now the moment that many of you have been waiting for, the results of our first ever Chinese language video festival competition, in which filmmakers from every corner of the globe were invited to send in short videos on the subject of Chinese culture and springtime. But before I announce the winners, a huge thank you to our fantastic panel of judges who have been poring over the many entries and graced us with their expert opinions. Not an easy task with so much quality to choose from. And now, without any further ado, the names of the winners, who have together produced a truly outstanding collection of films with some fascinating reflections on China and its wonderful culture. Congratulations to each and every one of you for your wonderful submissions, and thank you all for helping to make the first festival such a great and hopefully a memorable success. All that remains for me to do is thank you for watching and to urge you all to be brave and have a go at learning the fascinating Chinese language. You won't regret it. See you next year, or as they say in China, Ming Niang Zian.
在新加坡长大的时候，我们就从小学的中文，这是也是算是我们的祖先的语言，因为新加坡70%都是从中国移到南洋来的，所以中文对我也是我们的母语，所以这次。 有机会庆祝中文日也是对我们是很有意思、很有感情。那么让我再祝福中文日。你好，中文
，Dear friends, I send you my best wishes on this special day. Today we celebrate Chinese language, a language that joins together a rich variety of cultures and traditions, and also now one of the official working languages of UNWTO. When tourism starts, languages will help us rebuild bridges and make new connections across borders. The growing interest in the Chinese language will also help people from every part of the world learn more about Chinese culture. They will be more encouraged to visit and experience it for themselves. And the social and economic benefits of tourism will be felt well beyond the sector itself. Until we meet again, for now, I wish you all the best. 谢谢，中文丽，祝福中文丽，我们明年再见。
你好，中文日。你好，中文日。你好，中文日。你好，中文日。你好，中文日。你好，中文日。
感谢联合国中文日，
谢谢中文日，
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 祝福中文日，
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 我们明年见，
我们明年再见，
祝福中文日，
祝福中文日，
再见。